गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबडी, दिस इज नाइन्थ लेक्चर. वी हैव टू सॉल्व, दिस इज द लास्ट एग्जांपल फ्रॉम द पार्शियल डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. द एग्जांपल इज ऑब्टेन द सीरीज सॉल्यूशन अराउंड एक्स इज इक्वल जीरो फॉर द बेसिस डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन एक्स स्क्वायर वाई डबल डैश प्लस एक्स इंटू वाई डैश प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस एन स्क्वायर इंटू वाई इक्वल जीरो. फर्स्ट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट दैट हियर x is equal to 0 is the ordinary point or regular singular point of the given differential equation. In last example, we do that all these things here. So here, first we know that here, what is the differential equation? We know here, y double dash plus p of x into y dash plus q of x into y is equal to 0 here. So it is equal to 0, it is equation number 1 here. So let us write the given equation in this form here. What is our equation? The given equation is x square y double dash plus x into y dash plus x square minus n square into y is equal to 0 here. So this is given equation here. So what we have to do here, we have to divide throughout by x square. Then we get here, so it is divided by x square. It is divided by x square and it is divided by x square here. So x square gets cancelled. We get here y double dash plus 1x gets cancelled. It is 1 upon x into it is y dash plus x square minus n square upon x square into y is equal to 0 here. From this equation, it is clear that here, what is company equation? It is equation number 1 and the equation number 2 here. So here, it is 1 upon x here. So here, what is p of x here? Comparing 1 and 2, we get here p of x is equal to 1 upon x here. What is q of x? Q of x is equal to x square minus n square upon x square here. So here, it is the equation here. As we know that, what is the condition for the regular singular point or ordinary point here? If limit x tends to 0, p of x, or limit x tends to 0, q of x, or both diverges here, then x is equal to 0 is the singular point of the given differential equation here. From the first p of x, we know that here, limit x tends to 0, p of x is equal to limit x tends to 0, it is 1 upon 0. So it is your infinity here. So it is diverges here. So it is clear that here x is equal to 0 is the singular point of the given differential equation here. Now let us check the nature of the singularity here. So what is the condition here? So here we know that here limit x tends to 0, x into p of x. What happened that we have to see here? So limit x tends to 0, x into p of x is x cancel here. P of x is 1 upon x here. So it is equal to 1 here. So this is a finite number here. It is finite number here. So another is limit x tends to 0, x square into q of x here. What happens here? Limit x tends to 0, x square into q of x is, this is x square minus n square upon x square is the q of x here. So into x square minus n square upon x square here. So here this x square gets cancelled here. Limit x tends to 0 here. So we get here limit x tends to 0, x square minus n square here. Now x square 0, it is, you will get here, it is your minus n square. It is also the finite number here. So limit x tends to 0, x into p of x, and limit x tends to 0, x square into q of x, both are finite here. Therefore, x is equal to 0 is the regular singular point of the given differential equation here. Now, if x is equal to 0 is the regular singular point of the given differential equation, then what is the solution, power series solution for the given differential equation is y is equal to summation of n into x raised to n plus k, where n runs from 0 to infinity here. But remember here, we have to make some one change here. So here is the n here. If we write here n into x raised to n plus k here, you will be confused here. So here instead of n, we have right here m. This is small change in this equation because in the given equation, there is n here. So instead of that here, what we have right here? Our solution is y is equal to summation of m runs from 0 to infinity here. Am into x is to m plus k here. So same equation here. But what happens here? There is a n, so you will be confused here. So you will get, you don't get result here. So we have to make one change, small change. Y is equal to summation of am into x to m plus k, where m runs from 0 to infinity here. Now here, this is the solution. Suppose we write this is equation number 1 here. Now we require y dash, we require y double dash here. So differentiate this equation, we get here y dash is equal to summation of am into m plus k into x to m plus k minus 1. It is equation number 2 here. What is y double dash? Represent this equation again here. You will get here summation of am into m plus k into x raised to m plus k plus m plus k minus 1. It is equation number 3 here. So here, in every case here, m runs from 0 to infinity here. M runs from 0 to infinity here. So here, so this is y, y dash and y dash, y double dash here. So we have right here y, y dash and y dash in the given equation here. So what we get here? We get here x square. It is y double dash here. What is y double dash here? It is summation of am into m plus k into, it is not so here. It is m plus k into m plus k minus 1 into x into m plus k minus 2. It is equation number 3 here. So it is differentiation of this y dash. It is y double dash here. So m plus k into m plus k minus 2 minus 1 into x into m plus k minus 2. Now it is your x here. Plus x into summation of am into. What is y dash here? It is am into m plus k into x into m plus k minus 1 here. Now here plus x square minus n square as it is here. Plus x square minus n square into y is summation of am into x into m plus k and it is equal to 0 here. Now we have to solve this equation here. So it is your x square here, m plus k, it is minus 1 here. It is minus 1 here. So it is x raised to 2 here. Here x raised to m plus k minus 2 here. So minus 2 gets cancelled with plus 2 here. So our first term becomes here summation of am into m plus k into m plus k minus 1 into x raised to m plus k only here. Because this plus 2 gets cancelled with this minus 2 here, we will get here x raised to m plus k here. Now here is the x here, x raised to 1 here. Here is the x raised to m plus k minus 1 here. 1 gets cancelled with this minus 1. So you will get here plus summation of am into m plus k into x raised to m plus k here. Plus, now here is the x square here. Now x square multiplied by x raised to m plus k, you will get here x raised to m plus k plus 2 here. So it is multiplied by x square plus summation of am into x raised to m plus k plus 2 here. Remaining minus n square here. It is minus n square into minus n square. This term remains as it is here. So minus n square into summation of am into x raised to m plus k and it is equal to 0 here. So now combining the equal power of x. So it is x raised to m plus k, here is x raised to m plus k, and here is also x raised to m plus k here. Combining the equal power of x here, what we get here? It is summation of everywhere n plus from here is m plus from 0 to infinity here. The bracket of am into here is m plus k into m plus k minus 1. Here is the plus m plus k here, plus m plus k. Here is the minus n square here. Here is minus n square. So here x raised to m plus k here. So here combining the equal power of x here. Here is x raised to m plus k, x raised to m plus k, x raised to m plus k here. So here it is as it is here. Summation of m plus from 0 to infinity m plus k into m plus k minus 1. Now here is the x raised to m plus k term, m plus k, and here the last term is minus n square. It is as it is here. Now remaining term that we have is same here. It is summation of am into x raised to m plus k plus 2 and it is equal to 0 here. Now here, so this is the equation here. So we have all this thing here. Now next to that here, we have to solve this term, bracket term here. So it is summation of am into m plus from 0 to infinity here. What is the bracket term here? Multiply throughout by n here. You will get here m square plus mk minus m plus mk plus k square minus k. Here is plus m plus k and it is minus n square here. So we know that here m square plus twice mk plus k square, you will get here m plus k bracket square minus m bracket here m plus k. Here is the plus m plus k and it is your minus n square here. So plus m plus k plus your minus m plus k gets cancelled with each other here, remaining only m plus k bracket square minus n square here. And we know that here it is nothing but a square minus b square, a plus b into a minus b here. So for that all this term here, we can write here m plus k plus n into m plus k minus n into x is to m plus k here. So for all this bracket term, we can write only m plus k plus n into m plus k minus n into x is to m plus k here. Now this term as it is here, plus summation of m into x is to m plus k plus 2 is equal to 0 here. So this is the equation here. Now let's do that here. What we have to do here? We have to find out the lowest power of x here. What are the lowest power of x here? How we get that here? By substituting. By substituting m is equal to 0. By substituting m is equal to 0, we get lowest power of x here. Which is the lowest power of x here? By substituting m is equal to 0, we get here x is to k here. And what is the term here? The term is a0. It is your a0 into k plus n, k minus n, and into x is to k here. So by substituting m is equal to 0, we will get here, this is the term here, it is lowest power of x here. By substituting m is equal to 1 here. So what is the lowest power of x here? Lowest power of x is to k plus 1. And what is the term here? By substituting m is equal to 1 here, we will get here a1. By substituting m is equal to 1, we get here 1, k plus n plus 1 and k minus n plus 1 and x is to k plus 1 here. So this is the equation for that here. So these are the first two terms for substituting m is equal to 0 and m is equal to 1 here. So here we have first these two terms here. So we get here a0 into k plus n into k minus n into x raised to k plus a1 into k plus n plus 1 into k minus n plus 1 into x raised to k plus 1. These are the two terms here. Now remember here, it is m plus from 0 to infinity here. For m is to 0, for m is to 1, these are the two terms here. So that's why here we have right here m plus from 2 to infinity here. Instead of 0 to infinity, we have right here, it is your 2 to infinity here. So remaining terms is as it is here. Plus am into m plus k plus n into m plus k minus n into x raised to m plus k plus summation of am into x raised to m plus k plus 2 and it is equal to 0 here. So this is the equation here. But what we have to write here? We have to replace this 2 by 0. Then what we get here? We get here a0 into k plus n into k minus n into x raised to k plus a1 into k plus n plus 1 into k minus n plus 1 into x raised to k plus 1 plus. Now here we have to replace m plus from 2 to infinity by m plus from 0 to infinity here. Then what we have to do here? Everywhere there is m, we have to write here m plus 2 here. So here we get here m plus k plus n plus 2 m plus k plus 2 minus n into x raised to m plus k plus 2 plus summation of am into x am into x raised to m plus k plus 2 is equal to 0. Now this is the equation here. Now here if you can check here, if you substitute m is equal to 2, whatever you get term here, by substituting m is equal to 0, you will get the same term here. Now here this is the series solution for it is Bessel differential equation. Right hand side is equal to 0 here. Now here this equation is true only if the every power of x vanishes here. So x raised to k is equal to 0. What we get here? A0 into k plus n into k minus n, it is equal to 0. It is equal to, suppose it is equation number 4. And k plus n plus 1 into k minus n plus 1, and b is just equal to 0 here. So it is your a1 into. So here these are called the initial equation. These are called the initial equation here. Now here from these two equations are simultaneously true here. Now from if we take the fourth equation here, so here a0 is not equal to 0 here. So what are the value of k is equal to plus n or k is equal to minus n here. So these are the cases here. K is equal to plus n and k is equal to minus n here. Now by substituting k is equal to plus n, k is equal to minus 1, what happens here? If we substitute k is equal to n, a1 is equal to 0. If we set to k is equal to minus n, a1 is equal to 0 here. So these are the conditions here. Then what is the recurrence relation here? We can write here. What is the recurrence relation here? recurrence relation is here is here is here is somewhat it is I think it is your am plus 2 we require here am plus 2 here no here is am here is am plus 2 it is remaining here so now remaining remember x ratio m plus k plus 2 also equal to 0 coefficient of x ratio m plus k plus 2 also equal to 0 the remaining term is a m plus 2 into m plus k plus 2 plus n m plus k plus 2 minus n at plus an is equal to 0 here plus an is equal to 0 here now if we transfer am to the right hand side here what happens here it is you will get here it is minus am here so it is equal to minus am here and therefore am plus 2 becomes here minus am upon all these things here so here this is nothing but the recurrence relation here so here we have like here recurrence relation again here and the conditions here so our recurrence relation is am plus 2 is equal to minus am upon m plus k plus 2 plus n into m plus k plus 2 minus n here so this is the recurrence relation here now here and what are the conditions here our conditions are k is equal to n and a1 is equal to 0 here so this is the condition here so it is your first condition here by substituting k is equal to n here now here if we substitute k is equal to n what we get here am plus 2 is equal to minus am upon k is equal to n if k is equal to n here we get here m plus k m plus 2 plus 2n into if k is equal to n this gets cancelled this here m plus 2 here so you will get here am plus 2 here now substitute m is equal to 0 m is equal to 1 m is equal to 2 here so here you will get here m if you substitute m is equal to 0 you will get here a2 a3 a4 a5 solve these equations here now here without wasting time we come up to this here and the solution y is equal to summation of am into sa to m plus k where m runs from 0 to infinity here now similarly this is homework for you here now substitute m into 0 1 2 3 4 you will get here a0 a1 a2 as substitute value of a0 a1 a2 a3 a4 from this equation here you will get the solution this series solution for this here now for the second condition is k is equal to minus n and a1 is equal to 0 here solve this equation here so in this way here you can solve you can obtain the series solution around a is equal to 0 for the Bessel's differential equation here so it is last lecture here now what is the tactics for this solving this example here remember here first we have to prove that here we have to show that here x is equal to 0 is the ordinary point or regular singular point for the given differential equation here then only this y is equal to summation of am into x to n plus k here is the in the example there is n that's why we replace n by m summation of am into x to m plus k here we replace this here only this is a small change in this equation here otherwise we have used the same equation y is equal to summation of n into x to n plus k here then we have to solve this y dash y double dash substitute the values then you will get the initial equation then you will get the recurrence relation by using the initial equation you will get some conditions here and substitute that condition in the recurrence relation you will get the series solution here okay so this is the last lecture this is lecture number 9 for the mathematical methods in physics partial differential equation here so this is the end of the chapter have a good day